What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about deploying Windows 10 21H1 upgrade using SCCM 2103. So let's get right into it. All right, so within your SCCM server, the first thing that we need to do is make sure that you are running the latest and greatest Windows ADK. At the moment, the latest one is 19.041, okay? Next thing that we need to do is download 21H1 ISO to your server. Once you have it, we are going to right-click on it and we are going to mount it. So once we mount it, I am actually going to take all these files and drag them and drop them into a network folder, which I created within my SCCM server. So just take all those files, drag them and drop them into that network folder, okay? Once you're done, we are going to open up your SCCM console. And from here, we are going to go into software, expand the operating system node. We're going to right-click on operating system images, click on add operating system image, and you're going to get the wizard. We're going to click on browse, and we're going to browse to that network shared and go inside sources and pick the install.wim file. Select it and click on open. We are going to enable extract a specific image index from the specific WIM file. I'm going to click on the drop down menu and I'm going to pick number 3. Make sure you pick your flavor, which is 86 or 64 bit. This is up to you. I pick 64 bit. Click the drop down menu and pick your language. I pick English and then click next. From here, you're going to provide general information. This is up to you. Once you enter all that information, click on next. A nice little summary, next, and green check marks, which is always a good thing, and then close it. Now, within your operating system image node, we are going to select your new imported image and we're going to right click on it and pick on distribute content. Click next here. Click on add, and then you're going to pick on distribution point. You're going to pick your DP and then click OK. Click next, next again, green check mark, and then close it. Now, once you distribute your operating system, at the bottom of the console, you're going to see a status. It says in progress. Before I continue, I like to wait until it changes to green, success. Once it does that, then I could continue. Now, the next thing that we need to do is go inside operating system upgrade packages. We are going to right click on that node and click on add operating system upgrade package. You're going to get the wizard. Now, from here, we are going to click on browse and we're going to go inside that network path where we drop those ISO files into. Now, we need to pick the root folder. Now, the root folder has the setup.exe file, okay? Pick that folder and then click on select folder. And from here, we are going to select extract a specific image index. Once you do that, click on the drop down menu and then pick your version. For me, I picked number 3. Now pick your flavor. Are you going to do 86 or 64 bit? I did 64 bit. And then click on the drop down menu and pick your language. For me, it was English. Now click on next. From here, you're going to provide general information such as the name, version, and the comment. Once you're done with that, click on next. You're going to get a nice little summary. Click next here. It's going to start exporting that single image. Once it's done, you're going to get all green check marks, which is always a great thing. And then click on close. Now within here, you're going to select your upgrade package, right click on it, and you're going to pick distribute content. Click next here. You're going to click on add and then click on distribution points. Pick your DP, click OK, click next, next, green check mark, then close it. As always, I like to wait before I continue on the next step. If you look at the bottom on the console, you're going to see that that upgrade package right now is in progress. I like to wait until it changes to green, to success, before I continue. Now, next thing that we need to do is create a task sequence. So get inside your task sequence node. You're going to right click on it and then create a task sequence. We are going to pick the third option, which is upgrade an operating system from an upgrade package. And then click next here. Provide a sequence name. Description and then click on next. You're going to click on browse and then you're going to pick your upgrade package. Once you pick your upgrade package, click OK. If you have a product key that you need to enter, go for it, enter it. If not, you could click on next. If you're including any software updates, you know, modify the option here, click next here. If you're installing any applications during the upgrade process, you know, add the applications in here. click next, a nice little summary, click next, and you're done, and then close it. Now, once you're done with your task sequence, we're going to select your task sequence, right click on it, and we're going to pick deploy. From here, within the collection, we need to click on browse. You're going to get a nice little warning, so just click OK and then pick your collection. Now, for this video, I pick all workstations and click OK. I clicked on next. I left everything as a default. You can't really make any changes other than the purpose, so just make it available. Click next. I left everything that has a default with the scheduling, user experience, default, alerts, default, distribution points, default. So it's basically next, 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 next. But those three options, it really depends on your environment. So you have to configure it to fit your environment, okay? Summary, click next, done, close it. Now within the collection of all workstations, I am going to choose upgrade. That machine is the one that I am going to actually upgrade with the latest Windows 10 operating system. Now, this is the machine that we are going to deploy our upgrade package into. It's already part of the domain. Now, if you go inside the control panel, it already has the SCCM client installed. It is already talking to the SCCM server with no problem. If you go to actions and you pick machine policy retrieval and click on run now, it's going to retrieve the you know, whatever policy that we configured. For us, it was the upgrade package. At the end of the video, you're going to see a quick run through of the upgrade package in action. So hopefully you guys enjoyed that, and that's it. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.